Hey Matt, how was your weekend?
Oh, it was okay, I guess. I was just hanging out with my buddy Steve. His girlfriend left him a Dear John letter on Friday, so he was pretty upset about it.
What's a Dear John letter?
Basically, it's a breakup letter. He found it on the kitchen table.
Oh, that sucks. I hate when people break up with me but don't meet face to face. You know, over the phone, or text messages, or letters, or through other people.
Yeah, me too. My ex broke up with me over the phone. It was pretty upsetting in the moment.
Yeah, I understand. I do not feel like there is a real end to a relationship when someone breaks up with me indirectly, but I guess breakup letters were sent more before phone calls were commonplace.
Yeah, Dear John letters were more common at the time because long-distance phone calls were quite expensive, and not every house had a phone. It was also more difficult for people to travel at that time.
Oh, so when did people begin to say Dear John letter?
Actually, this phrase first started to be used at the end of World War II. John was the most common name in North America, particularly the United States. When the housewives of soldiers would divorce or break up with their partners, they would leave a breakup letter. With the name John being the most common name at the time, the letters would usually open with Dear John or My Dearest Johnny.
When you think about it, it's kind of cruel. Those letters seem nice when you read the opening lines, but they are not as they appear to be at first glance.
Yeah, I mean, I guess everyone has their reasons. It was a very rough time for everyone.
I realized that in English we use the name John a lot, such as John Doe or expressions like, I have to go to the John. Why is the name John so popular?
Well, the name John is so popular because it comes from characters in religion, John the Baptist and John the Apostle. Baptists form a major branch in the religion of Christianity and perform specific religious ceremonies for Christians. Apostles are the most devoted followers of a religion. Devoted followers are those that are the most loyal and follow something, in this case a religion, the closest. In Christianity, Jesus had 12 apostles. John was one of them. I guess people wanted to be associated with very devoted followers, as they were seen to be important.
What other English names come from similar sources?
Many English names come from religion, including Matthew, Simon, Peter, James, Thomas, Philip, and Andrew, among many others. As well, many traditionally female names come from religion, like Mary, Sarah, Rachel, Leah, Deborah, and Delilah.
I heard that many English names have meanings. What does John mean?
Some names have meanings, yes, while others only refer to significant cultural figures and don't have meanings. In this case, John is just a reference to a religious figure. In some cases, people may name their children John because it was also the name of kings and other important people throughout history, and they want their children to be named after them.
I know some people call the toilet the John and say things like, I need to go to the John. Why do they say it like this?
So, some language scholars have looked into this, and some of them think that the phrase, use the John, is just a less direct way of saying what they actually want to say. This expression is used to not sound so direct as saying, I need to use the toilet, or anything more specific. Another example of saying things in a less direct way would be to say things like, I am between jobs if you are unemployed, or my dog passed away instead of my dog died. The understood meaning is the same, but the words that are said are not as direct. Getting back on track, there is some truth to the use of John as the name of choice for the toilet, because it might be referring to the inventor of the first flush toilet. In the 16th century, there lived a man named Sir John Harrington. He was one of the godchildren of Queen Elizabeth I. It was said that he was the inventor of the first flush toilets in England, so people started calling the toilet the John as a result, to honor the man who invented it.
That's quite interesting. So how do we use these phrases?
So, a Dear John letter is a noun, meaning a breakup letter. We can say things like, Steve's girlfriend left him a Dear John letter. We don't use this phrase too often, but it is still used in TV shows and in movies. Using the phrase John in place of saying the restroom in conversation happens occasionally as well. We can excuse ourselves by saying, I need to use the John. Or, if someone asks where someone is and they're in the restroom, we can say, that person is in the John.
Hi, I'm Kelly, and I'm currently learning English with Matt. We're trying to explore the language in a fun way, and we'd be happy to have you join us.
If our content gave you a little bit of help, and you learned something new today, please be sure to subscribe to our channel and give this video a thumbs up. We hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll see you next time.